Well, I guess we have to talk about this now. Good Sunday and good weekend. What we have to talk about today is something that has happened in the last few days, which has been the changes, so to speak, that we have seen from Blizzard planned for 9.1.5, except they are not the changes related to the gameplay, they are not the changes related to the systems and whatnot. It is something much more deep, much more meaningful. Boobs, okay, tits, cleavage is mostly what Blizzard is planning on changing. Because in the last few days we have gone through a few modifications applied by Blizzard to some of the things in-game, which I'm sure you all knew about. Some obscure painting in the SI7 building of Stormwind and in Ravenholt. Paintings which have been slightly modified, you can say. One painting used to have a woman, a pretty smug woman, to be honest, looking at you with contempt, and now it's been changed to be much more dull, honestly, and boring, but more importantly, much more covered. There is very little cleavage being available here. And then the other painting, you don't even have to worry about the cleavage. The author, the painter, has gone through a complete change in style, so he decided to change the woman, the half-naked woman, into a ball of fruit. I see oranges there. I think that's a pear, perhaps. And then there is like a slice of lemon on the side. That's what changed. So, pretty clearly, there is some toning down of sexualization in these paintings. And then there is a last change, which happened at the same time, related to the Big Love Rocket. The icon of the Big Love Rocket mount has been changed to be pretty much a one-to-one version of the actual in-game mount. One might say, well, they just wanted to make it look more like the in-game mount, right? Well, not really, because this was always supposed to be an inside joke. It was always supposed to be a pun. The icon of the mount with tons of hearts in the background was supposed to look like a penis, basically, right? That's a dick, okay? That is a dick. And the name of the mount is Big Love Rocket. And what you do with a mount, you mount on top of it. So what do you do with the Big Love Rocket penis? You mount it. Haha, penis joke, okay? That was the whole thing. And instead, it has gotten changed to not basically resemble a penis anymore, unless you have some medical issues I don't know about. So, of course, people have put two and two together. In this case, three and three together. They looked at these three things and they went, haha, Blizzard is going through a lawsuit for sexual harassment and misconduct in the workplace, particularly perpetrated by men, against everyone, but also and particularly in several cases against women in the workplace. So with these changes toning down the sexualization, the accusations of misconduct in the workplace being often of sexual nature, people were like, this is just a ploy. This is just essentially a marketing scheme trying to pretend like Blizzard is changing, and they are doing so by doing what? Removing boobs from the game? That's how they plan on changing the world. Now, this is not, to be fair, the first time that any of this happens. You know, this is Jaina and her cleavage in Hearthstone getting toned down, for example. You had, over the years, the complete cover-up of Sylvanas. Remember the iconic Sylvanas midriff, which, once upon a time, Chris Metzen's daughter asked why was she half-naked. So Mr. Metzen came to a conclusion, let's get rid of her midriff, and now we get all the way to the last part of the Sylvanas' story when she's turned into a moss-worn armor-wearing gal and she looks like this, even more covered up. You even had Jaina, good old pre-model upgrade Jaina. She also had her own midriff showing as well as her cleavage, pretty in sight. And then she changes to basically cover up most of it completely. It's a sick model, by the way. She looks very cool, but I'm just pointing out the cover-up. This type of change has always been in contrast with how guys have been shown, to be fair. You know, you had BFA. The entirety of BFA, you had been hanging around with Bomsamdi, which is basically shirtless. Big, tall, buff, muscular, and shirtless. You, in fact, had an entire movie of glistening, sweaty, buff muscles on shirtless orcs. That's the entire movie. Big, buff, shirtless orcs. What's also funny in that movie is that the orc-esses, the orc ladies, are nowhere near as undressed as the orc males. For example, you had characters like Garrosh. The entire marketing part was a big, buff, shirtless guy, orc. You have a Garrison follower back from Warlords, who is still, by the way, one of your followers right now in your Covenant, which is Croman, a guy in his underwear. And the big bad guy of this expansion is a gigabuff Giga Chad guy who is also shirtless, shoulders like a linebacker type of guy. So it looks like the covering up over the years have followed mostly girls and mostly about their upper half, whether it's the midriff or it's the cleavage. That's what Blizzard has mostly tried to cover up over the years. What's also more confusing about these changes is the fact that the ESRB, the rating board that judges what is in a game, has rated WoW for a while, pretty much since forever, for teen, T14. So they do expect, you do expect, if you get into WoW, to see blood and gore, you expect to see crude humor, you expect to see mild language, suggestive themes, use of alcohol and violence. So this is all within the scope of the game. It's not that Blizzard was doing something illegal that needed to be covered up or anything. We even went, if you remember, last year to something like removing one of the iconic lines from Garrosh, "Watch your clever mouth, bitch," said to Sylvanas back when they were fighting, the Horde was fighting the war against Gilneas, and that word, the meanie word, was removed, which was always funny because it was being said by Garrosh, which at the time was a genocidal maniac who was basically asking Sylvanas to kill, to genocide half of her forsaken army against the wall of Gilneas. And the bad part about that entire ordeal was apparently the word bitch, not the death of countless people. You know, that's kind of putting things in perspective. So this sparked a debate. This sparked a debate as to why would this happen now? And also, why are these things being changed by Blizzard? What's the reasoning behind this? Some people have come out with the explanation of China. China, I'm not going to go into too much detail, but they have been cranking down on the sexualization of video games and even movies and TV series and whatnot that are going to be allowed in the country. So this might be a way, as we will see, many, many developers and publishers are bowing down more and more to China because of the amount of revenue they can milk out of the country. So they are trying to just appease the new way that China is going for when it comes to video games. Although this doesn't seem like as important of a matter, since, you know, China has its own client. You can make changes just for the Chinese client without having to do it for all of the rest of WoW. Then, of course, you have the other camp, which is just virtue signaling. This is just being politically correct. This is just for good boy points because of the lawsuit, because of the bad PR situation, the PR nightmare, in fact, that Blizzard has been going through for quite a while, even before the lawsuit, you know, for quite a few months. This has not been a pretty nice period for Blizzard, so they were just trying to change something for the sake of looking like they are understanding, like they are changing. Sorry, we did something wrong. Look at how committed we are to our change. We are removing boobs from our game. And of course, these changes are pretty confusing because what we are getting is basically a bunch of paintings from 15 years ago that very likely the majority of the player base did not even know existed, and they get changed. It's not that Blizzard is tackling, if they were thinking about the over-sexualization, if that is even a problem, they would have tackled something like slut mugs, something like overly revealing armor pieces, rather than just picking a bunch of super old paintings, right? What is also particularly confusing and bizarre about this change is that it doesn't look like it's going to do any good to anyone, and in fact, it's just going to piss off both camps, because the camp that believes this is just virtue signaling, the camp that believes this is just a meaningless act from Blizzard that is not going to change anything, and they're doing this just because they want to be praised for how progressive they are, is going to be angry because they see this and they're like, yeah, this is just a ploy. This is just a marketing ploy, a PR ploy that has no scope whatsoever. And then there is the other camp, the camp of people who did think Blizzard needed to show some commitment to change, that the workplace harassment lawsuit and the general atmosphere within the Blizzard's workplace needed to be changed. Fire people, hire new people, change the whole system within Blizzard and show that you are changing, and they wanted to see some change. That camp would also be annoyed at this because they also see it as something meaningless. They would also see it as just a pretend change that doesn't really accomplish anything. And as I said before, this is sort of like a big mistake from Blizzard, just like the Mage Tower Challenge appearances for the artifact weapons, because 9.1.5 was looking like an easy win for Blizzard. plenty of positive changes to reel the population and the popularity of the game back in. Not really anything to be angry about or to be annoyed about. Plenty of problems being fixed. So, you know, it was an easy win. It was an easy bring it home, good reviews, applauses for Blizzard, etc., etc. And instead, the first bump was the lack of artifact appearances, which would have gotten some sour taste at the back of people's mouths, you know, it's kind of annoying. And this one is another one. This is another bump, which is going to ruin their free win with this patch, because this is not going to accomplish anything from either side. It's not that this is something very divisive, where half of the population is totally in support of this and the other half is totally against this. This doesn't look like it's going to appease much of anyone, because the people who didn't think these changes were going to do anything are going to be annoyed at how Blizzard is trying to change things that need no changing. And people who did think some things needed changing are going to be pissed, because they see these changes and they are like, what is this? These are just like two paintings. Like, what are they going to do? So they're going to get annoyed as well. It is also pretty confusing how obscure these old changes are, because they are targeting some pretty obscure things, right? Not too many people knew about this, which leads to question, why exactly are they being changed? Perhaps because these are the only things we have seen so far. Perhaps this is just a start. Perhaps all we have seen is the proverbial tip of the iceberg, or at the very least, only the head of the snake. The rest has yet to come. So maybe in a while, maybe we will get to see the full point that Blizzard is trying to make in a few days or perhaps weeks. Because for now, it does not make too much sense. Maybe we will get to see the full scope later, but for the moment, these changes do look like they are kind of weak coming from Blizzard. Look, guys, we had people doing the cube crawls and harassing women on the workplace, but at the very least, these boobs on this 15-year-old painting are gone. There you go. I've not even seen women, since these changes are particularly aimed at the female form, I've not even seen women being particularly happy about this change. Mostly being confused and or slash annoyed at the idea that somehow the woman's form and the woman's body needs to be covered up, as opposed to what I've already shown, the male form being plenty naked and plenty shirtless being available in game. So I hope that we're going to get to see more of this, not because I agree with it, but because at the very least it would explain what Blizzard is trying to do. Because if we just stop at these handful of changes, they just look bad, in my opinion. It doesn't look like it's going to do anything other than annoy people. So for the time being, we can stop here and wait to see if any more of this is going to come in, or if this is just all. Let me guys know what you think about this and whether or not you agree with the changes. For now, we're going to leave each other to the rest of the Sunday and the rest of this weekend. Thank you guys for watching the video. You can support the channel by liking the video, leaving a comment down below and subscribing to the channel, as well as subscribing to some more OnlyFans accounts, since it looks like it's going to be much harder for you to use WoW paintings to help you now. So see you guys soon. And in the meantime, or maybe the entire change is just Americans. Killing, good. Dismemberment, good. Cannibalism, good. Boobs? Jesus Christ, think of the children!